On the last couple of pages, we were looking at the images that were created in mirrors, and we saw that it was really the same thing as images created in lenses. So when we had that equation for lenses, we end up with exactly the same equation for mirrors. And the magnification equation, which worked for pinhole cameras and lenses, is also still going to work for mirrors. So we're going to solve some problems which are really not any different than the ones we were doing for lenses, but now they're for mirrors. Let's have a look. What will be the height of an image produced from a 9.2 centimeter tall light held 25 centimeters from a diverging mirror with a focal length of negative 10 centimeters? So what will be the height of the image? So HI is the question. 9.2 centimeter tall light, so that's HO equals 9.2 centimeters. It's going to be held 25 centimeters from the mirror, so the distance of the object, that's SO, equals 25 centimeters, and F equals negative 10 centimeters. So we have our two formulas, 1 over SI plus 1 over SO equals 1 over F, and we have M equals HI over HO equals negative SI over SO. And that second one, the magnification equation, if I were to look back at the magnification equation here, I'm looking for HI, but I also don't know SI. So maybe from doing with this with lenses, you'll remember that often what we did was we use this equation first to find, say, the missing SI, and then we could put in SI here to find HI or other unknowns. So let's start with 1 over SI plus 1 over SO equals 1 over F. And 1 over SI, I don't know what SI is. SO is 25 equals 1 over negative 10. So 1 over SI equals 1 over negative 10 minus 1 over 25. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to punch in negative 10 and press the reciprocal button, subtract 25 reciprocal, then press equal sign to find out what all of this is equal to. And then finally, because this is the reciprocal of SI, I need to take the reciprocal of the answer to find out what SI is. And I find that SI is equal to negative 7.14. And that's all in centimeters because I decided to just leave everything in centimeters. Now I can use that formula, the magnification equation formula, but I'll use the HI over HO equals negative SI over SO part. HI is what we're looking for. HO we said was 9.2. That's equal to negative SI. Well, SI we just figured was negative 7.14. So those two negatives are going to cancel, and SO was 25. In order to find out what this is, I can just do 9.2 times 7.14 divided by 25, and that'll tell me what HI is. So when I punch that all out, I get HI equals 2.63 centimeters, which is exactly what I have written over on this side this time for some reason. And that looks good. So that's just standard, but let's have some more fun now with a more complicated one. A light bulb and a screen are both in front of a converging mirror with focal length 40 centimeters. The distance between the screen and the light bulb is 20 centimeters. Okay, how far from the screen should the mirror be held so that a clear image of the light bulb can be focused in the screen? Okay, so these two things are fixed, the bulb and the screen, and this mirror, we can move it closer or further away. We can move that mirror to different locations wherever we want in order to get a nice clear image on this screen. So one thing I noticed about this diagram is that it does not include SO. SO is the distance from the object to the mirror. So SO would be this entire distance here. That's SO. And now, the connection between SO and SI is that SO equals, let's see, 20. Yeah, we'll use centimeters, 40 centimeters, 20 centimeters. SO equals 20 plus SI. That's one equation. Another equation that we have is the thin lens equation, or the mirror equation in this case, that says 1 over SO plus 1 over SI equals 1 over F. So SI, I'll just leave as SI. This was SO, sorry. And SO, I can fill in with 20 plus SI equals 1 over F, and F was 40. Okay, now what do we have? We have 20 plus SI. Right, so, oh yeah, we have a case here where we have two fractions which are being added, and we need to put them together. And so I think we're going to need a common denominator by multiplying each denominator by the other. So I'm going to take 1 over SI, and I have to multiply that by 20 plus SI on the top and bottom. And then I have 1 over 20 plus SI, and I'm going to have to multiply that times SI on the top and bottom. And that's equal to 1 over 40. Oops. Okay, this gives a common denominator of, I'll just multiply it out, because of SI times 20 plus SI, so that's 20 SI plus SI squared, that's the denominator. And if I look at the numerators, I have 20 plus SI again. So that's just 20 plus 2 SI. And that's equal to 1 over 40. In order to get this all sort of on the same level, get rid of that nasty denominator, I'm going to do that thing where we multiply the denominators each on the other side of the equation. So I'm going to take this 40, and I'm going to multiply by 20 plus 2 SI, and I'm going to take this 20 SI plus SI squared and multiply it by this 1. So the 40 times that is 40 times 20 is 800, plus 40 times 2 is 80 SI equals 20 SI plus SI squared. Just to be clear again where that second term was coming from, I took the denominator over here and I multiplied it by 1. I think I'm going to leave a zero on this side of the equation. It looks like we're going with the quadratic equation here. I'm going to start with my SI squared. I take my 20 SI and subtract my 80 SI. So that's minus 60 SI. And then I have to do minus 800. Once again, I guess we should use the quadratic formula. So the quadratic formula is negative b. It's going to tell us what SI is. So negative b is negative of this. The negative of that is 60. And then plus or minus the square root of b squared. So negative 60 squared minus 4a. A is just 1 times c. And c is negative 800 all over 2 times a. Well, a is just 1 again. Oh my goodness, I somehow dropped my 2 here. So now we're gonna multiply. Let's see, I'll start by multiplying this 40 times this stuff. 40 on the other side of the equation, so 40 times 20 is 800. 40 times 2 is 80 SI, 40 times 2 SI. Yeah, equals 20 SI plus SI squared. That's going to require the quadratic formula. I can't put those SIs together, so I'm going to start by making one side equal to 0. I'll make this side equal to 0 so that SI stays positive, SI squared. Then I've got a 20 SI on this side, but I've got a subtract that by 80 SI, so that's minus 60 SI. Then I'm going to subtract the 800 from this side, it shows up on the other side, so minus 800. The quadratic formula will tell me what SI is, and the quadratic formula says take negative B. Good, that's 60. Less or minus the square root of B squared. So negative 60 squared minus 4 times A, which is 1, times C, which is negative 800, over twice A, which is 2 times 1. So if I work this out, SI equals 60. Plus or minus, what's in that square root sign? That square root sign, we get 82.46, and that's all going to be divided by 2. So if we do, let's see how much room I got here. I got just barely enough room. If we do 60 plus 82.46 and divide by 2, we get 71.2. Now, what happens if we do 60 minus 82.46? Well, 60 minus 82.46 is going to be a negative number. Divided by 2 is a negative number. So it would give SI is negative. And you might remember that SI is negative means that you end up with a virtual image. So what happens here is that if we make SI too small, then what we're going to be doing is we're going to be bringing this screen up really close to the bulb. And yeah, it's not even, it's going to be a virtual image, so it's not going to appear on the screen or anything. So in this case, a negative doesn't make any sense. So we're not going to include the negative, and we're just going to say it's 71.2 centimeters. We've got a valid reason for discarding the other answer, and that's it.